days are never ending, when the nights are feeling lonely. There's a place that I can go, where the birds are free to roam. In the sky, flying high, over fields of green. And where the stars inside the sky, where the last ones shine and bright. Pushing through the storm tonight, we'll be burning on and on and on. Where the stars inside the sky, we're the last ones shining bright. Pushing through the storm tonight, we'll be burning on and on and on.
Hello Libra. This is Inspire 2016 with your weekly tarot reading for the week commencing the 16th of October until the 22nd of October 2017. The first card for you is representing, how do you feel about yourself? Your card is the Page of Wands. You are experiencing a creative restlessness within you that is just waiting for some sort of expression, or you may be on the verge of some sort of discovery or new phase of life. The Page of Wands represents the sudden creative spark that comes to you, suddenly and unexpectedly, and that starts you down the road of a new creative vision. Thus, he encourages you to express yourself and your individuality with light-hearted abandon. Listen to your unconscious mind and follow your creative urges, even if you are worried about being the lonely voice crying out in the wilderness. With persistence and a balanced perspective, even the immature desires of the Page of Wands can be transformed into a beautiful creative vision that can change the world. Similarly, the Page of Wands indicates that you need to be positive and spontaneous but not overly impulsive. Your enthusiasm impresses others, but if you become impatient or quick to anger or lose interest, you will put others offside and you will waste time in your creative projects. With the Page of Wands, you are inclined to give anything and everything a go. If you are enthusiastic or passionate enough, you embrace the opportunity to start out on a new journey or project and see where it takes you. You do not necessarily have a solid plan in place, nor do you really know where you are headed, but you do know that you are excited about the possibilities. You are enjoying being busy and involved in various activities and projects. You like the freedom of being able to choose what you will work on today, and hopefully it is different from what you worked on the day before. Oftentimes, the Page of Wands is a messenger, bringing you inspiring or unexpected news, new information or a welcome surprise. It may be the birth of a child, a new and inspiring idea that a friend has, or a new opportunity for you to be involved in to change the world, such as a community project. His news is nearly always positive and welcomed because it is often associated with change and creation. The second card for you is representing, what do you want most right now? Your card is the Five of Pentacles. What do you want most right now is the end of financial problems in your life. If you have suffered a loss, know that there are people around you who are willing to help. There is always a solution and always a way out, so either open your eyes and go to it, or close your eyes and let the inner light guide you. Often, what has caused these financial problems is a matter of your own emotions. Greed will lead to loss, anxiety will lead to error, possessiveness will lead to solitude. By focusing on the material, you lose sight of your spiritual development. You may be rich for a while, but all will be lost if you learn nothing. On a psychological level, there may be a difficulty with your relationship to money and material things. If money becomes the primary motivating force in life and the gauge by which you judge your worth, the lack of it may produce anxiety and a sense of being excluded from the good things money can provide. For example, if you are unfortunate enough to encounter financial difficulties such as the loss of employment or an investment gone belly up, you may fall into the trap of losing faith in your ability to recreate a positive financial situation for yourself. Therefore, you should not only consider your actual financial circumstances but also your attitudes toward money. What fears do you have around money and wealth? Are you anxious about never having enough, or do you have faith in your ability to manifest what you need to live a prosperous, fulfilled life no matter what your circumstances? Often wealth is based as much on your psychological state as your actual financial state. In a world that often equates success with financial wealth, the loss shown on the Five of Pentacles can be a humbling blow to your self-esteem and sense of self-worth. This loss can occur in any number of ways, but even though an external event may seem to be the cause, this card often reflects that the loss is something you have brought upon yourself. There is a spiritual loss that often precedes or accompanies loss of material wealth. The Five of Pentacles can also point to a time of being alone, feeling abandoned, ignored, and unwanted. You may be excluded from group events or you are being ostracized by others. You are in desperate need of support and comfort from those who actually care. The third card for you is representing your fears. Your card is the Ten of Swords. You are afraid of painful ending in some areas of your life. There will be a forceful re-evaluation or elimination of your previous attitudes about life, your views about yourself and what is important, and possibly your plans for the future. Despite the initial trauma and torment associated with this change, the imposed re-evaluation can be a very positive thing. It is important to understand that while the means of your demise may not seem reasonable or fair, your previous thoughts and attitudes really need to change in order for you to reach a better place in your life. Rather than dwelling on the painful ending, it is important to look ahead and realize how these events free you up to completely reshape your life and choose a new direction for yourself. The Ten of Swords may also indicate that you are resisting an inevitable ending because you are deeply worried about how much it is going to hurt you. However, what you are doing is delaying the inevitable and possibly making it even worse for yourself because you keep trying to put off something that needs to happen anyway for your own personal transformation. For example, a relationship may have come to an end but you are still intimate with your ex because you cannot bear to let go. This is only drawing out the pain much longer, and it is best to completely let go at this stage. Sometimes, the Ten of Swords may reflect fear of ruin, even if that ruin has not yet occurred. You are always be thinking of the worst case scenario and planning for the worst, even if it does not happen. This is only creating unnecessary fear and anxiety for you, and it is important that you return to the energy of the Nine of Swords and run a reality check as to whether things are as bad as they seem. The Ten of Swords represents an old situation that ended very badly. You are still carrying around wounds from that situation, but you have buried them so deeply that you do not realize they are still present in your life and still hurting you. This old pain needs to be brought up and dealt with once and for all, so you can liberate yourself from these deeply inflicted wounds. It may be difficult to experience the pain again, but at least you are releasing yourself of this pain and allowing it to pass from your life. The fourth card for you is representing what is going for you. Your card is the Six of Cups. You want to return to the happy memories of your past, whether as a child, teenager, or adult. Oftentimes, though, these memories are indeed a thing of the past and reflect aspects of your life that have since vanished. You may feel that the only way to connect to this happiness is to escape into the past where you can reflect on your happy and beautiful memories, instead of dealing with current challenges. This is fine if you are simply taking a walk down memory lane, but it is important that you live in the present and accept your current circumstances rather than always living in the past. Oftentimes, there is nothing wrong with looking back at the good times for inspiration when things are not going so well. In the midst of change and crisis, the Six of Cups suggests that looking back at what you have endured is a good way to assure yourself that, whatever trials lay ahead, you will meet them and you will overcome them as you overcame others. You need to take time out to heal, look back on the past and all the good that lies there. During this period of reflection, there is no need to focus on the negative. Instead, bring all of the positive energy from the past into your present and your future. The fallen cups are now full and upright again, but with blooming flowers that cannot be spilled or washed away. Now that you have looked back, the way forward will be clear and enlightening. The Six of Cups can represent a return to a familiar environment or to a childhood place. You may return to your hometown, to your parents' house, to your high school or even kindergarten. You could be going to a high school reunion or reconnecting with a childhood acquaintance. A teenage sweetheart or past lover may turn up again. Allow yourself positive, nostalgic memories of childhood, friends and family. If you can, spend time with younger people. The source of your problems may be in past events that are triggered in the present. We are made up of many parts, and inside we still have the little child and adolescent we were with all of its experiences and feelings. This can lead to the inner child reacting strongly to certain experiences, situations and feelings in the present, based on experiences of the past. Working with your inner child and getting to know where these feelings come from can change that and enhance your choices in miraculous ways. When we are being playful, spontaneous, creative, intuitive and surrendering to the spiritual self, our genuine authentic self, who we know deep within us, our real self is being welcomed and encouraged to be present. The fifth card for you is representing what is going against you. Your card is the Nine of Swords. You are full of worry, anxiety and not being able to sleep because your thoughts are running at 100 miles an hour. You are working yourself up and becoming incredibly stressed and anxious when, really, this does not have to be a complicated issue. You have a tendency to get very worked up about how bad a situation appears, losing sight of what it is really happening and what opportunities are available to you. What is needed here is for you to stop and objectively examine the reality of the situation. Bring yourself back to earth by uncovering your fears and anxieties and working to reduce the impact of those fears and anxieties on your life. Know that it is going to be okay, no matter what. Overall, your worry and despair may actually be causing you harm. The more you worry about something, the more likely it is you will manifest your worst nightmares. Do not let this nightmare become your reality. Take a deep breath and realize that life is not as bad as it seems, and that the more you worry, the more harm you are doing to yourself. It is also possible that you have already worked through this period of worry and depression and are beginning to make recovery. You may have recently come to the realization that it is not as bad as you had made it out to be, and you are beginning to relax and calm yourself about what was once a terrifying situation. You may also find that your dreams are very telling at this time. Use a dream journal to help you analyze what is happening at a subconscious level. The last card for you is representing the likely outcome that you may have. Your card is the Three of Cups. You are open to helping others, which in turn means that others are open to helping you. It is about spending quality time with your loved ones and your friends. It is a very sociable period. You will find a harmonious balance between meeting your commitments and spending quality time with friends and family. This is a great time to let your hair down and indulge yourself a little. You may be particularly drawn to the bar or restaurant scene, indulging in great food, wine and cocktails. You may also be celebrating something special, such as a birth, engagement, wedding, reunion, or birthday. For the moment, even though life's problems go on, you can take time out to forget about the hassles of the everyday world and enjoy the company of your friends and loved ones. Such respites are often needed before and after periods of high stress, to stop you from getting burned out emotionally or physically. When this card appears and you are experiencing a high level of stress, take some time off to recuperate and gain the support of friends before returning to reality. More broadly, the Three of Cups indicates the end or conclusion of any problems you have been experiencing, particularly those that relate to your interactions with others. A compromise will be found which will serve all the interests of those involved and will allow for a more harmonious environment. You can facilitate this process by bringing about positive change within yourself and changing your attitude and the way you react or deal with what is happening. Treat the situation with compassion and give the benefit of the doubt where possible. The Three of Cups represents community and groups of people coming together to focus on a common goal for the greater good of others. You may find that by reaching out to others and banding together, you can achieve a huge amount in terms of sharing your positive energy and passion with others, benefiting the wider community. It is a sign that you should seek out other people to celebrate your successes along with you. Last but not least, the guidance card for you is the Golden Solar Dragon. The Golden Solar Dragon who has come to you now is asking you to balance your life, listen to your inner wisdom and become a leader. Dare to speak your spiritual truth. Hold the vision of a fifth dimensional world. Protect those who are less capable than you are. With the support and guidance of this dragon, you can be a living example to many people. When you aspire to be a wise spiritual leader, remember that true masculine power, used with wisdom, helps you and those around you to feel safe. Spend a little time each day focusing on, or imagining, the sun shining onto your third eye and sense the light codes that the golden solar dragons are directing towards you.
I hope that you enjoy everything, and if you like the reading, just please click subscribe and you will get instant notifications every time we publish a new video right to your YouTube. Thanks.